Please welcome back John Gossman.
Wow, that was a great session. I hope you're all enjoying the show so far. Now, earlier this month in California, we announced that Microsoft is joining the Cloud Foundry Foundation. In my keynote, I talked about how ecosystems are such an important part of our approach to open source in the cloud. So now I'd like to introduce you to a special guest to talk a little bit more about the role community governance has in open source. Abby Kearns is the executive director of the Cloud Foundry Foundation, and she has agreed to answer us a few questions remotely. Abby, welcome to OpenDev.
Thank you. I'm so excited to be here.
You lead the Cloud Foundry Foundation. Can you tell us a little bit more about the Foundry's charter?
Yeah, absolutely. So the Cloud Foundry Foundation is chartered with holding and maintaining the IP for Cloud Foundry. But more than that, and I'd say the most important piece, is fostering a sustainable ecosystem and community around Cloud Foundry. So keeping that community engaged and ensuring the continuity of Cloud Foundry for a very long time.
And what does this mean for the enterprise? What role does the foundation play for customers looking at the cloud for their open source workloads?
Well, for developers today, what we found in our research is that developers get excited when they are able to participate in open source projects within their work. And as many of these companies are transforming and becoming very software-centric, there's an opportunity there for the companies and organizations to participate as never before in the upstream project and direction of technology, while also allowing their development teams to participate more and be more active in open source projects and open source communities. There's a tremendous amount of collaboration and innovation that can occur when all of these companies lean in to participate in open source.
We're excited to be part of the Cloud Foundry Foundation. Last year, Microsoft also joined the Linux Foundation. Can you talk a little bit about the relationship between these multiple foundations and communities and their role for the governance of open source?
Yeah, absolutely. So small known fact is Cloud Foundry Foundation is a collaborative project underneath the Linux Foundation. So we spend quite a bit of time working and collaborating with the Linux Foundation, but also with the other projects that reside underneath the Linux Foundation. Projects like Cloud Native Computing Foundation, the Open Container Initiative, or the Node Foundation. We work closely with these other projects, sharing ideas and best practices, but also continuing to collaborate across our communities.
Now, in addition to Cloud Foundry, there are some other projects that are part of the foundation. Can you tell us a little bit about the service broker work?
Absolutely. So last year, we undertook an effort to look at the Cloud Foundry Service Broker API, which is how services are attached and bound to applications on the platform, and looked at opening that up to other projects and communities. That project and that conversation turned into what is now known as the Open Service Broker API. And that extends the Cloud Foundry Service Broker across other projects and communities like Kubernetes. So we've worked closely with the Kubernetes community as well as CNCF to continue to invest in that and build that out. So started small with Google and Pivotal and grew into IBM and Fujitsu and Red Hat and many others that really contributed to make that an amazing technology and continue to innovate on that to this very day.
Thanks for that explanation, Abby. Finally, can you tell us what the ecosystem's reception is of cloud vendors like Microsoft joining this governance forum?
Well, I am super excited about Microsoft joining the Cloud Foundry Foundation. I think Microsoft has been a participant in the community for some time, establishing and building the CPI for Cloud Foundry on Azure, and continues to be an active part of our community. So I'm really enthusiastic to have Microsoft participating in the Cloud Foundry Foundation. And I think there's a tremendous amount of potential as we think about users that are running their application workloads on Cloud Foundry and looking to public clouds. There's an opportunity to run on Azure on top of Cloud Foundry. And I think there's an opportunity to continue to grow and build that out with the service broker work, the work with Bosch, and as well as the extensibility into Azure.
Thank you so much for talking to us, Abby.
Thank you. Have a great time.
Okay, and with that, now back to the show.